What's going on, y'all? This is Damien from the DevSec Blueprint once again, and in today's video, I'm going to give you guys some tips on how to pass the AWS Security Specialty exam. Aside from the DevOps Professional Certification exam, this is the second hardest exam in my opinion, and I believe that sharing my expertise and experiences with the resources that I'm going to highlight will help y'all pass this exam. So without further ado, let's get right into it. All right, so before I go and explain the exam and get into all the other things that you should use to prepare for it, I will say this. In order for you to successfully pass the exam, I would highly recommend that you at least have the AWS Certified Solutions Architect Associate. The key reason why I say this is because the exam itself is really built on top of the foundational knowledge that you would get if you take the Solutions Architect Associate. That was the advice that I received before I sat for this exam, and I came out passing it on the first try. So I would highly recommend that you guys do the exact same thing. Let's talk a little bit about the exam itself now. So according to AWS's website, the AWS Security Specialty Certification Exam validates your expertise in creating and implementing security solutions within the AWS cloud. So the thing about the certification is that it's going to validate and confirm your understanding of specialized data classifications, data protections, and various architectures on how to implement security controls within AWS. You can also learn how to secure production deployments and make trade-off decisions regarding cost, security, and deployment complexity while meeting application requirements that are specified by your business. Now, this particular exam has 65 questions that are either multiple choice or multiple response. And it lasts 170 minutes or almost 3 hours. And it also costs about $300 USD. As far as testing is concerned or completing your test, you can test online at home if you like, or you could go to a testing center that leverages or uses Piercing View. If you want to find out more information about this exam itself, you can find the link to the webpage in the description below. So now that you guys have an understanding of what the exam is and you know where the exam guide is if you want to take a look at it, let's talk about some of the preparation resources that you guys should take a look into or that you guys should review. For starters, the Ultimate AWS Certified Security Specialty course created by Stefan Marek is one of the highest rated courses out there for this exam. If you don't know much about Stefan, let me tell you this, the guy is a legend. I've used his course material for almost every AWS certification that I have. Stefan is very good at breaking down complex concepts while being concise in his delivery. In addition to that, his course is about 16 hours of on-demand videos and recordings, and he also includes his course hands-on labs that you can do with him. Just know that, of course, it's going to cost you a little bit of money to leverage or use some of the services that are in scope for this exam. The next thing I recommend would be the AWS Security Specialty Focus Labs created by Wiz Labs. The reason why I'm saying this is because the majority of the questions on the exam are going to really be based on how much hands-on experience you have. They have about 54 hands-on labs that you can take to increase your skills that range across all of the key domains on the exam, like threat detection and incident response, infrastructure security, monitoring, and IAM. So you can choose whichever section you really want to focus on and just go crazy labbing. The only thing about this is that the hands-on labs themselves aren't free, of course. You do have to purchase them in order to get access to these labs, and the original price for them is $65.95 USD. Sometimes Wiz Labs does throw in a sale, so hopefully you can catch it and save yourself some money. Along with the course and Wiz Labs, I also recommend that you go and purchase the Tutorial Dojo's practice exams and reference their cheat sheets when you're studying for the exam. Tutorial Dojo's cheat sheets are exceptionally detailed and really cover all of the necessary points for each of the services that are in scope. On top of that, the practice exams themselves are quite close to the actual exam, if not harder than the actual exam. So if you purchase these practice exams, you'll want to consistently take them until you reach a certain score, like the high 80s. If you're constantly obtaining an 80% or above on the practice exams, then I am definitely certain that you will pass the security specialty. The last thing I recommend you guys take a look at is a talk given by Becky Weiss. In this particular talk, she covers the basics of network security, the process of reading and writing access management policies, and also data encryption. What I like about her is that she's really good at breaking down and really explaining all these concepts in a way that anyone can understand it. So make sure y'all watch that. All right, so before you sit for the exam, I would highly recommend you pay attention to the following services that I'm about to call out: CloudWatch, CloudTrail, KMS, IAM, GuardDuty, Inspector, Organizations, MACI, WAF, Shield, Security Hub, Detective, VPC, Config, and Systems Manager. I am almost certain y'all are gonna see these services very frequently on that exam. So make sure you pay close attention to them and study them in great detail. And that wraps up this video, y'all. Thank you so much for your support, and I hope that you were able to take away some good advice from this video. If you found it helpful at all, or you think that it would be super beneficial to anyone who is studying for this certification, please make sure you like, subscribe, and share with that person and also with your friends. Comment down below and let me know what your thoughts are of the video. And don't forget that you can find the link to anything that I've mentioned in this video in the description. So with that being stated, I'll see you all in the next video. Later.